Well, I think that they were obviously very excited to get started again. I don't think it would have mattered who they competed against. From going all the way back from the time in March up until now, not having any certainty, and in the start of the year not having any certainty, I knew they were looking forward to it. And it was a roller coaster ride, not knowing even when they got back in September. You know, we started out and we had some restrictions on it, and as we got closer and closer, you could see the excitement building. And Carson-Newman is obviously a very competitive team in our conference, but also, you know, at NCAAs, they always have outstanding swimmers on their team. Yeah, well, I think that one of the things that helped us through this is our approach with our athletes, because there's a lot of complexities in college with every team, and in ours, which is a conditioning-based sport, you know, first and foremost, but there's it's highly technical as well. I mean, you know, there are plenty of people that can work out to the, you know, till they're blue in the face, but if they're giving back that conditioning level with lack of technique or being able to put races together. One of the things that comes to mind is a short track ice speed skater versus the longer version. You know, there's an art to the short track versus the longer track, and it's the same in swimming. There's a lot of nuances that goes into racing. But one of the things that we tell the swimmers, because of the class schedules, the different breaks, you're here for the school year, then, you know, 98% of our team, 99% of our team is home in a different training environment under different eyes, and which everybody is faced with, but we try to encourage them to always err on the side of conditioning. You know, I mentioned to you earlier, a push-up's a push-up, a run's a run, a jump is a jump, and then we with their exit meeting, we talk about different strategies to work on to look for a better athlete symmetrically. You know, if you're weak in the legs, we try to send you home with some things that you can work on. If you're weak in your core, which is the stabilizing force between being on top of the water, whether you're a long access or a short access swimmer. So then you throw in the complexity of COVID. And I think that they handled it great because, like we talked about earlier, we're all in the same boat. So they handled that tremendously, and we harped on control what you can control. And if we lose 2 weeks, then you know that you're going to be on your own. But that's part of the overall educational experience while you're here, learning to be your own man and your own woman, and be able to adapt to the circumstances which, you know, you find yourself in. As I was talking about in dual meets to you a little bit earlier, and also David, for the post article. Mm-hmm. You know, you can win an event, and if the other team goes second through 10th with their depth, you still get outscored by a point, because you can only score your top three people, and there's a premium put on winning. So we knew the meet was going to be close. What you hope for when a meet is close are minimizing your mistakes, mm-hmm. just like in any sport. We had a 400 medley relay that got disqualified. So that's a loss of 2 points. Really, a loss of 2 points for us is really a 4-point swing, because they're getting that additional. You're losing the two, they're gaining the two. So you have to make up for those 4 points. So as we came down the stretch and we were talking to the captains, they were coming up, and you know, they always want to know what's going on. We were heading into the last few events, and strategically, we sent them over to their teammates and said, okay, you know, Marcel in the 200 free, mm-hmm. listen, we have no chance if you can't pull out a victory in the 200 free, which is a lot of pressure. And the thing that makes us happiest as coach is, you know, what you do under duress against a pretty good swimmer. He was able to eke out a 2/10 victory in that. And that set us up for the 400 IM. And it was still a daunting task, because 1-2-3 against good teams is really, really difficult. And so we 1-2-3'd that, and because we didn't want to get into, based off of the way the meet was going in the setup. If we're just doing a championship format, I think if we put our four up, our four best in a free relay, that in the end, when everybody's on the same footing and you're trying to make NCAAs, I think we'd give them a nice run. But I knew in the setting with how they were using their personnel and how we were using ours, that second, if we could secure a second, that we could eke out the win. And that's exactly what they did. We had talked to Marcel, Kevin especially. He trains in Kevin's group. And, you know, when Kevin and I talk and when he's critiquing swims and, you know, from race to race, from meet to meet, and over the course of the training season, early on last year in a lot of races, he was very aggressive on the way out, and we felt like he was burning his legs too much on the front end of the race. And so we worked with him a lot, and by the time we got to NCAAs, he started to really pick up the short course yard style of swimming, and knowing that, you know, your legs have to be there. And you could see already in our time trial meet and our blue gold meet, which we were just doing with our own teammates, that he's getting more and more comfortable. And if I'm not mistaken, that's probably his best in season time. Going against Matt, I knew that the race was going to be close because they're both NCAA All-Americans and they're both really, really good swimmers. And it was really going to come down to, in that situation, a touch out. We kind of knew it. And I think that Marcel, coming off the last wall, had a little bit better turn, and he had his legs down the stretch. And I think that was the difference in him getting to the wall just 2/10 ahead, and that's the fine line between victory and defeat, right?
That is crazy.
I think in the end, the meet was setting up to be the same. When we started the second session, we were only 4 points up on their women, and the 200 medley relay started the second session. And they beat us in that relay, and with their placing, they went up on us. So heading into the second event of the second session, they were ahead. I knew that with the people that we had situated and the events later on in the second session are some of our strengths and some of their weaknesses. So I felt that they could overcome any of the setbacks. You know, you still had to go out and win the races, and they did just that. I mean, Kate in the 500 free, Anna in the 200 back, Sarah in her races. And I think that the biggest difference between us pulling away on the women's side versus the men's side is right now, I would say that we have our strongest swimmers on the women's side are the junior-senior class at this point. And the freshman and sophomore class are continuing to come along. But that junior and senior class, when they were freshmen and sophomores, it was the same thing with those people that were juniors and seniors. And I think like anything in all sports, if the juniors and seniors, they kind of have an understanding of what needs to go on. On the men's side, we had Aran, who was out and didn't participate, and he's a senior, and pivotal events that he's in. I mean, last year he was the second fastest 200 flyer in NCAA, and we lost that event. He was the top 8 in the 100 fly. We lost that event on the men's side. And I'm not saying that under the circumstances that he was going to win, but it's just like a chess piece. If you have him there, it means that you're moving somebody else to another position that they're going to be stronger, because a lot of times you're moving someone in that position when they're out. Every team is faced with it. So you and the guys and the girls, they have to understand, and that's why I was also saying that it was a perfect experience to start our season under the circumstances for all of our newbies, because they got a taste of what it's like. And this is the prep situation because of all the variables. You know, our times compared to our top times that we swim at a conference championship or NCAAs, we weren't even close to those times. But it doesn't matter. The atmosphere and the understanding of pressure and doing what you need to perform in that situation has a direct result of what's going to happen in the end. It just might be that the times are faster. I would say on the 400 medley relay, on the backstroke leg, we're a little bit stronger. On the breaststroke leg, we're a little bit stronger. And then on the fly leg, they're stronger. And so it kind of, those pieces even it out, and it always puts it into an anchor position. That's why in relays, whether it be a free relay or a medley relay, your anchor is really, really pivotal, because usually when you're racing good opponents like Carson-Newman, it really always comes down to the anchor position, and you got to have someone on there that is not going to blow their start, not going to blow any turns, and is going to balance their energy in a highly emotional situation to be able to do that. Add to that her versatility, as I mentioned earlier. I mean, we can use her in the 53 through the 500 free if we really had to. 200, 400 IM, she can swim 100 breast, 200 breast. She can swim some backstroke if we want to. And the thing that really, really excites me about her this year is her emotional stability in terms of being put into a pressure situation. It was for the first meet, given the circumstances, I was really, really happy and also proud of her, because when she was younger, if something didn't go her way, sometimes she would let her emotions really take hold. And once your emotions control you, instead of you controlling your emotions, it can sometimes get ugly, and we were really proud of her in those pressure situations. Well, we always have a bit of an uphill battle, because obviously we have a lot of respect for them. They're the five-time defending men's and women's conference champion, the five-time defending national champions in our division. But along that run, our teams have never been better, as indicated by our records and our top time performances. And we're proud of that. But like any competitor, we want to win. And we usually, if we hit a good cycle, and, there's a lot of variables that are out of our control. But the one thing that I know that will be there on both sides and emotionally ready to put it on the line, and hopefully if both teams are ready to go, we should have two pretty darn good duel meets with the women here on Friday and the men on Saturday. And then add into it for me on a personal level, my daughter swims here for Wingate and my son swims for Queens. And so there's family smack talking back and forth. But in the end, I think we bring out the best in them and they bring out the best in us.